All right, the Goa government in a written reply in assembly has denied any deaths due to oxygen crunch during the second COVID wave after center. Now, Goa government has denied oxygen-linked deaths. The Goa health minister has said that at no point in time, oxygen supplies at Goa Medical College ran out of stock. Thus, no death has been reported due to non-supply of oxygen. For more on this, I'm joined by my colleague Mayuresh on this story. Mayuresh, thank you for joining us. Very shocking comments there because, you know, we have also reported extensively during the second wave how Goa Medical College witnessed several deaths. And now the government is claiming in assembly that nobody died due to lack of oxygen. This is barely days after there was a written reply in Rajya Sabha where the center said the same thing.
Also, it's a very shocking reply from the Goa government. Because if you remember, yes, we extensively reported there was one day where more than 20 people lost their life in Goa Medical College. And there used to be a specific time every day. It was post midnight where the oxygen supply used to get dipped. And yes, Goa government has accepted that. And if you remember, there was one petition in Bombay High Court, Goa bench also, about the oxygen management in GMC, that is Goa Medical College. Even the High Court had clearly criticized the Goa government for not managing the oxygen supply. Goa government had also in the court clearly said that they are basically getting oxygen supply or getting oxygen from the differences, that is Karnataka and Maharashtra. So suddenly after entire this drama, which happened in the court also, now Goa government is Goa government on the floor of the house. The Vishwajit Rane was a health minister. He clearly saying that there was no death, which is very shocking.
Yeah, it's a major U-turn on the floor of the assembly. We'll have to wait and watch, you know, if there is any clarification or how the opposition, you know, if at all it plans to take up this issue. But like you said that, you know, Vishwajit Rane had earlier cited a drop in oxygen levels when that tragedy unfolded at Goa Medical College. Have we heard from the government yet? What is the rationale behind it? Is there a technicality? Because last time, remember, when the centre had said the same thing, there was a controversy and the opposition was gunning for the centre. The centre said that it's not their data. It is the data that they get from the states. But what is Goa's rationale behind claiming these, behind making these claims and making such a major U-turn when so many lives were lost to the second COVID wave?
See, as of now, we haven't heard anything from the Goa government except the statement which Vishwajit Rane made. But we are waiting for the official reaction from the state government itself, either by CM or Vishwajit Rane, because these were two men who basically at the center of a controversy during this entire drama which happened, and where people were continuously losing their life, the patients were losing their life in GMC. It was, as you said, yes, it was Vishwajit Rane who first indicated that this could be the lack of oxygen. And after that, we saw that every day, at least 10 to 15 people lost their life, and the opposition had also basically pointed out that there is a shortage of oxygen in GMC. But as you said, as you asked, that no official comment has been come from the Goa government and also from Health Minister and Goa CM.
All right, Mayuresh, please stay on with us. I'm joined by Durga Das Kamath of the Goa Forward Party. Mr. Kamath, thank you for joining us and giving us your valuable time. How do you see this? The Goa government saying that nobody died due to oxygen crunch during the second wave.
See, it is ridiculous that, you know, a government on the floor of the house yesterday has said that at no point in time oxygen supplies at GMC ran out of stock. And there were no deaths due to a shortage of oxygen. This is utter ridiculous. Let me remind, on 11th May 2021, Health Minister Vishwajit Rane was on record, which was reported by New York Times, Times of India, your own channel, Indian Express, and various other national media, that the deaths happened due to the shortage of oxygen. Why is that BJP government talking now? Why are they trying to mock the suffering of Goans? Are they trying to play with the sentiments of those people who have lost their loved ones? This is utter nonsense, you know, that they're lying on the floor of the house, blatantly lying on the floor of the house. It was the South Goa Advocate Association. It was the Goa Forward Party, along with the main petitioner was the South Goa Advocate Association. Then there are frequent of other NGOs such as Shruti Chaturvedi and others who had approached the High Court, and High Court had to intervene in the matter, after which it took almost a week or 10 days to restore the proper supply of oxygen, and due to which the deaths later came down. Approximately more than 100 people have died due to the shortage of oxygen in the Goa Medical College. And this was admitted by none other than the health minister himself. So I don't know why they are lying now. This is completely, you know, yes, mocking at the sufferings of Goans by the Bharatiya Janata Party government. This is a blatant lie. Everything is on record. I think you all should question the chief minister and the health minister on this. Why are they lying? Why are they fooling the people of Goa and the country?
Yes. Mr. Kamath, like you said, that it's a blatant lie, and you have also cited, in fact, our reporter has also cited these instances and cited the minister himself, and he had, in the month of May, said that there were deaths. There was a shortage of oxygen between May 11 and May 15th that led to so many deaths at Goa Medical College. And you are calling it a blatant lie, and we will continue to ask these questions. But can you tell us, and what do you think is the reason why the government is lying about oxygen deaths data? Is it to conceal the data, or is it to show that all was well in Goa? What do you think is the reason behind claiming this, that nobody died due to oxygen shortage?
See, the way answers are given by the government on the floor of the house, this clearly shows that the Bharatiya Janata Party has no regard for the family of the people who have lost their lives, who have lost their loved ones due to the lack of oxygen. You know, we ourselves were shocked by reading the reply yesterday, which was given on the floor of the house. I don't know if the health minister should come on record and answer this, because it's the health minister who has signed the answer to the LAQ, which has been submitted on the floor of the house. If the answer is given wrong, then the health minister should pull up the concerned officials for giving a false reply on the floor of the house. This is a breach of privilege of the house, lying on the floor of the house, giving false information to the members of the Legislative Assembly and to the people of Goa.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Kamath, for speaking to Mirror Now and sharing your views on this major U-turn by the Goa government, saying that nobody died due to oxygen crunch in the month of May or in the second wave. We'll have to wait and watch if there is any clarification, or whether the government gives us a rationale on why in the month of May the health minister cited oxygen shortage, but in a written reply in the assembly, the government has denied any such deaths due to lack of oxygen.